Welcome students, good morning to all of you for this fifth session on your income tax revision, CNTR income tax revision. Let me first confirm from all of you. Nishank, Kotla, SN Gupta, good morning friends. Let's take a confirmation from all and then we can just start with the today's session. Good morning, very good morning to all of you students. So today students, as I have told you in the last class, we will be doing also, Priya, good morning. We would be also doing the some of the questions from your modules, so that parallelly also a revision, a very comprehensive revision is taking place in terms of the practical questions as well. Sri, good morning. So even that practical approach is equally important as what we are doing, a quick revision of the various provision. So it's a balance of both the practical as well as the theoretical part. Both of them would be considered in the today's class. Now students, my request for all of you would be that in the chart that we have prepared yesterday, I think this chart that you will do, I have already have made a build up. First one is about the charging section, second one is about the deduction. In the deduction there are big deduction and small deduction. So in big deduction, just add two more sections, section 35 and section 35AD. You can just add, and also 35 herein, triple C, section 35 CCD, these sections. So just fill it up your chart primarily. Siva, good morning. Updates of CA, good morning. Anant Kumar, good morning, good morning. So students, in your yesterday's chart, what I have done is that I have just added in your list of big deductions these sections as well. And one more section, students, sorry, 32 and 32AD. Students, 32 and 32AD, so that the, at least the chart is very comprehensive. And you know, this is one segment of revision and another would be the second segment of revision. So that is one of the ways in which, Priyanka, good morning. So in this case, you will have a very clear cut aspect. Please copy to this particular part. We have only written section 32. What I have mentioned now, Trinath, good morning. What I have mentioned is, apart from 32, students, Trinath, apart from 32, 32AD also I have given the company, so that at least this chart is very comprehensive for whenever you have to do a quick revision, it will become very easier for all of you. 32, 32AD, 35, 35AD, 35CCC, 35CCD, and in the small deduction, students, herein, if you can just put across some more section, 35D, here last one, 35DD and 35DDA. So this is also one of the categories, because this is also a part of it, so that everything is covered in our discussion, in our discourse. 35D, 35DD and 35DDA. So that is also, I have made a mention of it on the small deduction side. So 30, 31, 36, 37 and 35D, 35DD, 35DDA. Some students will say, Avin, good morning. Some students will say that, sir, whether we have to remember the section number. I told you earlier also, students, section number need not be remembered. However, please, whenever you revise it, at least the visual memory, students, through that visual memory, 60 to 70% of your section you will easily come to know. So therefore, my suggestion would be, humble suggestion would be, that whenever you read it, read it with the sections, so that the through the visual memory you will be in a position to write the sections. But if at all you are not sure about what is that section number, please don't quote the section number. Simply put, what you are going to write as per the Income Tax Act 1961. In a simple wordings, you will just put across as per the Income Tax Act 1961. Shishant, good morning. So that is one thing which I will suggest to all of you, just to ensure that this chart, students, the list which is there, all of you just ensure to make it comprehensively placed. those who have just now have joined, students, in this chart I've just added few sections more. If you see in the big deductions, there is some addition, and also if you see in the small deduction, the last one, 35D, 35DD and 35DDA are the new additions. Now students, a quick recap of the depreciation. The biggest section which is depreciation, the quick revision of the same. We have discussed first the case of the basis of the depreciation, and in the basis of the depreciation we had SLM basis. Priya, that I'll let you know, let my live session get over, then I will give you my WhatsApp number. Primary, or we can create a group, a WhatsApp group. What I will do is that I will create a WhatsApp group of all the students, and they can join in that WhatsApp group, and we can take up your queries in that group itself. Okay, so I will be giving students, congratulations to all of you and also to me, I'll be giving you the WhatsApp number wherein all the students will join, and we will put across our income tax queries in that particular group, if at all you have any of the queries, and on that basis we can just keep moving further. Okay, so let's do it that way. And may just give me a couple of days time, I'll prepare that group and all of you can join that particular group. Okay, fine students. Just give me 2 days time, I'll make a particular group and we will be in that group itself. So students, 2 days time, maybe what else I've said, by Saturday or Sunday, today is Friday, just give me maximum 2 days time, because obviously you have to organize, structure it well, and there has to be a lot of like regulations. We will only put across the queries and all, and we will have to ensure that all the students who are in, students, just ensure that all the students who would be in, I will be just require that these students should be like the genuine students, because otherwise what will happen, you all know there is a huge nuisance which has been there as far as the students are concerned. So we just need to avoid that, because this is only for the study purpose that we will create that WhatsApp group for the queries in respect of your income tax, so that at least we are there with all of you till the last particular moment itself. Fine. So in that regard students, let's quickly run through this particular part. Then 32 students, basis of depreciation I have revised with all of you yesterday. 32, the basis of depreciation I have revised with all of you yesterday, and in that particular depreciation what we have said was is that there was an SLM basis of depreciation, and then there was a block scheme. In the SLM I have already given you, please revise only that question which I have suggested to all of you. Revise only that question which I have suggested to all of you. Based on that particular question only, based on that particular question only, you will come to know primarily how we are supposed to deal with it. So just revise that question, and only that question will come. Terminal depreciation, and if there is a surplus, what we have discussed, surplus to the extent of the deduction earlier allowed under section 32, surplus to the extent of the deduction earlier allowed, that will be allowed as deduction. Priya is suggesting that Telegram is best. Fair enough, Telegram channel or WhatsApp group, one of the two I have created, and that will be created primarily, whatever is easier for us as well. So surplus to the extent of the deduction earlier allowed, that was chargeable under the PGBP, and if the surplus is in excess of the deduction earlier allowed, then that excess will be charged under the head capital gains. Did you all got this one? So that is one thing that we have discussed in terms of the terminal depreciation, the SLM basis of the depreciation. So one thing you just keep in mind, do that particular question, and that should be all for your examination purpose. The second part students we have done was about the block scheme, and the block scheme, please remember that format. The format is what needs to be known, students. OpenWDV, add additions, less the money payable. Let's see, money payable. So money payable, which means that the buyer, how much he is going to pay me the money in respect of the asset sold, or if the asset is destroyed and it is insured, then how much the insurance company is going to give me the compensation in respect of such particular asset which has been destroyed. That is what we understand the term money which is payable. So that is one thing which is also to be considered, and we have seen various permutation and combination on the basis of which, finally the conclusion was whether the depreciation will be eligible or it will result into a short-term capital gain or loss. We have seen those combination. To conclude, students, to conclude, two situation should be present. Two situation should be present if the SSE wants to claim a depreciation under the block scheme. And those two situations are, number one, the block should remain in existence. What do you mean by the term block should remain in existence? It means that some of the asset should be there in the block. So the block should remain in existence. And number two is that the block, number one is the block should remain in existence. And number two, students, is that the second particular point that we have discussed was that the block should have a WDV. The block should have a WDV. So it should have a positive value and the block should have a WDV. Only when both the conditions are satisfied, that it will result into that the SSE will be eligible for the depreciation allowance. Only when both the conditions are satisfied, that the SSE would be eligible for the depreciation allowance. If one of the condition is not fulfilled or one of the situation does not exist, namely the block does not or has ceased to exist, that is the situation, or there is no WDV of the block. Why there is no WDV of the block? Because the money payable was over and above the opening WDV value as well as the actual cost in respect of the new additions. If that is the case, we will say that such situations, in either of the two situations, there would be a short-term capital gain or loss. So that is what we have discussed in our yesterday's example, the permutation combination that we have raised upon in this regard, isn't it? Now, apart from that, students, we have also discussed this point number two, which is about the condition for depreciation. And in the condition for depreciation, I have already told you, students, the condition of depreciation, I have already told you, possess, use, and entitled to hold. This is what you have remembered it. Possess, the person, it is a beneficial owner, students. It is the beneficial owner who is entitled for the depreciation. It is the beneficial owner who is entitled for the depreciation. So what we have discussed was, students, is that the possess, use, that SSE is in the possession of the asset, he is using the asset for the purpose of the business and profession, and is entitled to hold the asset to the exclusion of the other person, and is entitled to hold the asset to the exclusion of the other person. So I have also given you the examples on the basis of which we have concluded that the beneficial owner is what will be eligible for the claim of the depreciation. Now, students, there are important points that you can write over here. Just put across in this case, in the case of hire purchase agreement, because these are covered in module also. In the case of hire purchase, the hire purchaser shall be considered as the owner, and the case of lease, students, leases of two types, one is a finance lease or operating lease. In the case of lease, it is a lessor who shall be considered as the owner. Please make this two observations. In respect of the hire purchase, yes, Priya, beneficial owner should possess, use, and should be entitled to hold. So important points, two quick observations, students, please take a note of it. Hire purchase, in the case of hire purchase, it is the hire purchaser shall be the one who would be considered as the owner. Hire purchaser shall be the one who will be considered as the owner. And in the case of lease, be it a finance lease or it be it of operating lease, in the case of a lease, the lessor shall be considered as the owner. The lessor shall be considered as what? As the owner. So these are the two quick points that you should always keep in mind. Fine, students. Now, what is finance lease? I'll just quickly let you know. Finance lease, students, the period of the lease is quite large herein, and sometimes the lease is equivalent to the economic life of the asset. Sometimes the period of the lease is equivalent to the economic life of the asset, And the lessee is given an option, students, the lessee is given an option to acquire the asset somewhere towards the end of the lease period. Lessee is given an option to buy the asset somewhere towards the end of the lease period. This is what is known as the finance lease. Whereas in the case of an operating lease, students, operating lease is what? A short-term kind of a lease. An operating lease is nothing but a kind of a short duration lease. Operating lease is what? A short duration lease. That is what is referred to be an operating lease. So in the case of a short duration lease, which is an operating lease, what happens is that for that some part of the period, for that some part of that particular period, what happens? The lease has been given for that some part of the period. Like, it is just like a renting. It's as simple as renting. Operating lease is just like a renting. Whereas finance lease, the economic benefit of the asset is enjoyed by the lessee because the period of the lease is very high. In the case of this one, it is sometimes it is equivalent to the economic life of the asset, and the lessee is given an option towards the end of the lease period to acquire the asset. If that is the nature of the lease, then in that case it is a finance lease. Students, just we will do lot of analysis and final CA about the lease transaction. There are a lot of Supreme Court judgment in Shan Finance wonderful analysis. One full lecture I do it in the lease transaction for the depreciation allowance. But final CA, IPCC only remember this because it is there in your module. Okay, so logic and all, I will please excuse me for final CA to discuss the logic, because right now is not a time, but you have to remember this because it is there in your inter CA module. Okay, but let me give you one particular important observation so that you should not confuse you. Students, you have in accounting AS 19. If you have it in accounting AS 19, students, in your AS 19, students, in the case of a finance lease, it is a lessee who claims a depreciation. It is the lessee who claims a depreciation when it comes to the accounting part. When it comes to the accounting part. So that is one of the difference that you should always bear in mind. But income tax law, be it the finance lease, be it the operating lease, both the case, it will be the lesser who will be considered as the owner. Okay, so just keep this observation in mind, and that is as far as the second condition of ownership is what we have discussed now. Now the third point, students. Yes, Sushant. The third point is eligible asset and the rate of depreciation. So students, I have given you already this particular part, and from here now we are going to refer some practical questions from your module. But please come back to your chart, eligible assets and the rate of depreciation. Again, I'm repeating for the charts, those who are watching this lecture for the first time, the charts, you will get it in my Telegram channel, CA Durgesh Singh. It is already given in the description box. You can get it in my Telegram channel itself. So there you can get it, the charts. And come to this chart number 11. I have already have told you to go through this once. And hopefully you would have gone through it. So students, here, can you see this part, the tangible assets, this particular circling part which I have done it. The tangible assets, in that building is there, building which are not used mainly for residential purpose, primarily. So for them it is 10%. Yes, yes, so 10%. Okay, so it is like commercial building, students. Simply put, it is a commercial building, like our office and all. So that would be subject to 10%. Plant and machinery is the biggest category, students. The plant and machinery is the biggest category. Okay, and the third one, the first one is building, the tangible asset, building, plant and machinery, and furniture and fitting. So there are three different categories. There are three different categories of the tangible asset. And there is one category of the intangible asset. There is three different category of the tangible asset, namely building, plant and machinery, and furniture and fittings. Furniture and fittings. If you see the furniture and fittings also, it is only 10%. But for, as I told you, students, they are three different categories. Now please focus on the plant part. In the case of the plant students, herein the general plant and machinery, the general plant and machinery, primarily if you see over here, it is how much? It is 15%. The general rate, if nothing is given about the nature of the plant, if nothing has been given about the nature of the plant, then you will take up, simply put, you will take up what? 15%. Okay, now computer including its peripherals, computer including its peripherals, I'll just give an example here. The example would be herein, the example is its peripherals example, the example of the peripherals like UPS system, computer software, all would qualify for 40%. Now friends, please, you can add, if possible, in this case, books. In this plant, I can just write it over here. Here in books, even that is 40%. For books, even that is 40%. Energy saving device or windmill plant, students. I hope that all of you would have seen at least windmill plants. So that windmill plant also is at 40%. Now students, motor car is a very important category for all of us. And can you see there is something in red shade which we have done it? Students, that red shade is the amendment part. That red shade is an amendment part, and we have to be careful about this because this can be there as far as our examination is concerned. But before I go to the motor car in the plant and machinery, let me take you to the last category. And what is the last category? The intangible asset. So this is your part B. So part B is about the intangible asset. And in the intangible asset, students, we have got what? Know-how, patents, copyright, trademark, license, franchisees, or any other business or commercial right of similar nature. What is the rate? Rate is 25%. The rate is, students, 25%. So in respect of all these intangible assets, the rate would be at 25%. So that is how the split is made so far as the rate of depreciations are concerned. And what is the eligible asset? So first is a broader category, tangible, intangible. Then in the tangible, there are three subcategories, which is building, plant and machinery, and furniture and fixture. For the building, being a commercial building, the rate is 10%. For a furniture, being a for a furniture and fixture, also the rate is 10%. Fine. And rest of it, as you can see for yourself. Students, let me ask you a very simple question, and let me see how you all prepare the block. So let me put you on the test straight away. Supposing this is A Limited. Okay. And A Limited has got building, two buildings, 10 furniture, 3 plant, 3 machineries, or I'll say 5 machine. 5 machines, then say it has given you 1 motor vehicle. They are all business asset, by the way. 1 motor vehicle, 4 computers, 1 windmill plant, and 5 books. Okay. So 2 buildings, 10 furniture, 5 machines, 1 motor vehicle, 4 computers, 1 windmill plant, and 5 books. I want from all of you, how many blocks is going to be prepared in this case? That is my question to all of you. Hi Kalyan. Kalyan, this charts and all which is there, you will get it from our Telegram channel. Go through the description part. And this is the 5th lecture. So there are already 5 lectures which are already there in this channel. So you need to go through that 5 lectures, 4 lectures earlier, and this is our 5th lecture on the live revision on income tax. Tarun has said 7. Tarun has said 7 blocks will be prepared. Priya has said 3. S. Gupta has said 4. How many block students would be prepared in this particular example? Nishank. No, how many blocks, Nishank? See? Number of blocks, how many blocks you will prepare? So 3 students have given me the answer so far. Nishank. Priyanka. Priyanka's Nishank 7, Priyanka 5, Trinath 7. Siva 7, Deepak 4. So students, Nityasiri 6, so in all we shall prepare the total number of block students 3, 4. Now students, in this case Roshan 5, last try students, last 20 seconds before I get you the answer on the same, last 20 seconds. Ajay 3, last 15 seconds. Last 10 seconds. Anyone, last entry. Last 5 seconds. And then there you are students. Let's see how many blocks. First of all, they are all about tangible asset. In the question, it is all about tangible and intangible. There are, in the question, we can say there are 3 categories, there are 3 subcategories. And which are the 3 subcategories? Building. Building is one category. Plant is another category. And furniture is another category. Isn't it? Now, building you'll prepare. Even though there are 2 buildings, but you'll prepare only 1 block. One block, the OPWDV would be of 2 buildings. OPWDV would be of 2 buildings. Furniture. Furniture students, in the case of the furniture, even though there are 10 furniture, but only 1 block. Only 1 block. And the OPWDV would have how many quantity of furniture? Value I'm not given, but I'm just interested in knowing how many blocks would be prepared. Now comes the plant students. Be careful here. The plant is the game. Now this plant will have various class of asset. So how many blocks you have to prepare? Now in the case of plant, the subcategory plant has a different class of the asset, and therefore you will have to prepare for all the class of the asset in the subcategory plant one single block if they are subject to the same rate of depreciation. For all, again I'm repeating students, for all the class of the asset in the subcategory plant, you will prepare only a single block if it is subject to the same rate of depreciation. If it is subject to the same rate of depreciation. So if I have to go with this one students, if I have to go with this, then what I'll say, I have got 5 machines, 15% rate. One is 15% rate. Another is what? There are only 2 things that we have got. One is 15% that we have, and another is students 40%. For 15%, we have got what? We have got 5 machines. one motor vehicle. So in all, total is what? Total is six asset. This will be have one block. So this is one block, and this one block would be of 40%. So one block would be of 15% and one block would be of 40%. So here, if you see, for 40%, we have got what? We have got four computers. We have got four computers, one windmill, and five books. So in all, how much is there? In all, students, total is 4, 5, and 9. So 9 asset is there, and for which you will prepare one block. So in totality, the number of blocks 1, 2, 3, and 4. So 4 blocks is the answer. 4 blocks is the answer. So in this regard, the blocks that you have to prepare, one block, so in all 4 blocks has to be prepared. This is how it has to be considered. Did you all got this one? Motor vehicle 15% is the rate. General rate, if the question is silent, 15%. Only in the special cases that we will discuss it right now. Only in the special cases that the motor vehicle rate is 30% or 45% as the case may be. In the special cases. No. In this case, students, you cannot take 30 if the question is silent about the motor vehicle. You will have to take 15. That 30% or the 45% rate for the motor vehicle is only when the special circumstances exist. Only when the special circumstances exist. And that is one thing that you should always keep in mind. Did you all got this one? Fine, students. So that is one thing. Let's now see for the motor vehicle. What is those special circumstances when the rate would be at 30%? So on that note, all of you have copied on this one. Yes, Priyanka. All of you have copied on this. So that we will do the amendment on the motor vehicle. And then after that, we will switch to the practical question, students. If you are through with this notes, then I will just give you some write-ups on motor vehicle. Please let me know quickly. Fine, friends. So if the special circumstances, Ashwini, if the special circumstances, it will be a 5 block. Yes, if your motor vehicle, if it is falling in the special circumstances, then this motor vehicle here, because only question if it is there in the examination, motor vehicle, that's it. Then Ashwini, it is 15%. But if you say no, motor vehicle has got those special cases which has been mentioned also as per the amendment, then it is not forming a part of 15% block. It will then form part of the higher rate of block. So that would be a different block altogether. Yes, general rate would be done, Priyanka. In that case, general rate. Please now have a look to the motor vehicle, students. In respect of motor vehicle, what is the situation? Also incorporating the amendments, students. So, in our lecture of revision series, we will also take a cross and do a very good analysis of the amendments also. Because amendments, as we all know, they are very important for the examination. Your charts has got all the amendments that you need to know for income tax for your examination. Your chart, students, has got all the amendments that you should know for your examination. So, motor vehicle. Now, here in students, there are two categories which we have to first define. Or I'll let me put across this way, whether the SSC is using the motor vehicle MV, using the motor vehicle so whether the SSE is using the motor vehicle for the purpose, for the purpose of running them, in the business of hire. This is the question. Like, for example, Ola Cab, Uber, these are the SSE who are using the motor vehicle for the purpose of running them on hire purpose. Running them on hire purpose. So the answer can be yes or the answer can be no. Here is the example I have given you. Ola, Uber, they are the company. So in just a second. So the answer can be yes or the answer can be no. If the answer is yes, then this question is common to both of them, whether the motor vehicle is acquired from 23rd August 2019 till 31st March 2020 plus put to use on or before 31st March 2020. So this is the question that you need to answer for both of them. Here also same question, whether the motor vehicle is acquired from 23rd August 2019 till 31st March 2020 plus put to use on or before, put to use on or before 31st of March 2020. This is a question which is common for both of them. Another told you the answer can be yes or no. Again here, the answer can be yes or no. If the answer is yes, then students, congratulations, you will then be eligible for a higher rate of depreciation in this case. And what is the higher rate of depreciation in this scenario? Let's have a look. So if it is yes, this can go to 45%. If it is no, then the normal rate of depreciation for Uber and Ola car, it is 30%. The normal rate of depreciation for Uber and Ola car is 30%. Whereas if you see on the right hand side the box, which is there, like Reliance Industry, students, Reliance Industry also has got motor vehicles. Reliance Industry also has got the motor vehicles, isn't it? They also maintain the fleet of motor vehicles. So therefore, for them, the rate of depreciation, the general rate of depreciation would be 15%. But if Reliance Industry also has acquired the motor vehicle during this period, which period? 23rd of August 2019 till 31st March 2020. If Reliance Industries also has acquired the motor vehicle during this period, then in that particular case, students, then in that particular case, the rate would be 30% over here. And if the answer is no, 15%. So if you see, if the question is silent, students, if the question is silent, then we all take 15%. And that is what I have done in this question. If the question is silent, then you will all take 15%. And this motor vehicle is neither a building, motor vehicle is neither a furniture and fixture, so it will be considered as a plant, and because it is considered as a plant, it will be included. It will be included in that particular class of the asset, which is subject to 15% rate of depreciation. And combine all the asset and please make up as one block. Combine all these assets, which is at the rate of 15% in the subcategory of plant, and make them as the one block. Same exercise is for the remaining rate also, which has got the uniform rate 40%. Again, for that I've made a single block by combining all these assets, and I've made what? A single block. And that is what, students, the way in which the block has to be prepared. I hope that this point is all taken. If you are done with this, students, then let me then start with what your all of you through. So these are the tricky concepts, students, because see, simple sections every one of you are aware also, but you find income tax difficult because you are not comfortable with these concepts, and that's the reason why the income tax suddenly appears to be a difficult paper. No, it's not difficult. You just need to be conceptually be clear at least on certain areas of the syllables. That area, if it is in form control and you keep revising frequently, then you will have a great comfort so far as this paper is concerned, not only in your IPCC but also in your final CA and even thereafter. So students, you are, since stepping now into the professional world, it's so important that you do it as it ought to be done. Let's look upon to this, students, quickly now. I will going to the I take your module, students. PGBP. So in the block there is a huge list, students, there is a huge list, but just do whatever I have dealt with you. I have only added the books and all, but you just do what I have taught you, and that should be all in the chart. That much is sufficient for your IPCC level. Let's quickly run through this one. Illustration number one, this is in your module, page number 195, chapter number 4, 4.195. Illustration number 1. 4.195 is the page number. X, a proprietor engaged in manufacturing business, furnishes the following particulars: opening WDV of the plant and machinery. So therefore, net rate will be 15%. New plant and machinery purchased and put to use on 8th of June 2019, 20 lakhs. So again, this information is also about the 15%. New plant and machinery acquired and put to use on 15 December. Students, you may be aware of the fact that 50% of the normal rate of depreciation only would be applicable. 50% of the normal rate of the depreciation only would be applicable, isn't it? And in that particular case, you will have to accordingly will have to take up the 50% of whatever is the applicable rate. I think all of you may be aware of that. Computers acquired and installed in office premises on 2nd of January 2020, 3 lakhs. Now, students, we all know the block in which the first three category will fall is a 15% block, and this block is that of 40% block. Okay, now, students, there is a manufacturing angle also. We will do also the additional depreciation. compute the amount of depreciation and additional depreciation. Our focus right now is only the depreciation. Additional depreciation, we will do it immediately after I am done with this question. We will see that the additional depreciation benefit is available in respect of a manufacturing concern. We will see in our chart also. That chart has given that additional depreciation. So please be careful. The plant, see, they have made two blocks. This is two block. Block 1, B1, and this is B2. Can you see that? B1 and B2. So the normal depreciation, 15%. This is in respect of what? For first two asset. Because opening WDV will have a full 15% rate. The new plant which has been put to use on 8th of June, again, because it is put to use for more than 180 days, full 15%. It is that 8 lakh students, this will be at what rate? At the rate of 7.5%, meaning 50% of 15%. And also, this 40% for the first year, the rate will be 50% of 40%. So 50% of 40%, that is 20% on 3 lakhs. So that is what it would be. Additional depreciation, students, you will get it only on what? Only on the new plant and machinery. Now, that new plant and machinery, you will not get it on computers. It would be only on the normal plant and machinery. So if you see here, in this case, on 20 lakhs and on 8 lakhs, you will find there is an additional depreciation which has been given. And please understand, it is available only for this plant and machinery of 15%, not available for computers. So you find that even the additional depreciation rate, which is generally 20%, students, the additional depreciation rate, which is generally 20%, that 20% will also be reduced to 10%. That 20% will also be reduced to 10%. That is, the additional depreciation will be allowed only to the extent of 10% in the current year if the asset is put to use for less than 180 days. Then you will say, sir, then what about the balance additional depreciation? What we will do about the balance additional depreciation of 10%? Then the balance additional depreciation of 10%, you will take it in the next year. Now, students, additional depreciation is always on what? It is always on the actual cost. It is always on the actual cost. So this is always on the actual cost. So therefore, next year, students, next year also, when I said to you that the balance 10%, balance 10%, you will get it in the next year. That 10% will be on what? Not on the WDV. That 10% would be on the actual cost. Because the additional depreciation rate is applied on the actual cost of the asset. So if the balance additional depreciation has to be taken in the next year, then in the next year also, the 10%, which is the balance rate, will be on the actual cost and not on the opening WDV. Don't make this mistake in the examination. So that is how it has to be considered, students. Now, I'll come to the additional depreciation concept immediately for your benefit. But before I do the additional depreciation, I want a question to be answered from all of you. The question is, plant purchased on 1st January 2019 and put to use on 1st December 2019. What is the depreciation? What is the depreciation for previous year 1819 and previous year 1920? This is a question, MCQ based question. Plant purchased on 1st of Jan 19 and put to use on 1st December 2019. What is the depreciation for previous year 1819 and previous year 1920? So first is 1819, second is 1920. So you can just write first, this is the answer, second, this is the answer. Like that you can write. Write first, this is the answer, and second, this is the answer. First means, for 1819, what is the depreciation? And second means, for 1920, this is the answer. Quickly, students. Priyanka. No, that's 7.5% is for what? Ajay is saying First, no depreciation. And second, 7.5. Nishank, first, no depreciation. Second, 7.5. Priya, first, no depreciation. Second, 15%. Reason, Priya? Nishank, 7.5%. Deepak, first, no depreciation. Second, half depreciation. Priyanka, first, 7.5%. And second, it would be 15%. Students, as I told you yesterday also, that the condition for the claim of depreciation is two condition. One is ownership and second is put to use. That condition for the claim of depreciation is, one is the ownership and second is what? Put to use. So in that context, when put to use is also one of the condition for the claim of the depreciation, when put to use is the condition for the claim of the depreciation, then in that particular case, students, what we have seen is that unless the asset is put to use, you cannot claim the depreciation. So if you see in the previous year 18-19, yes, Siva, Trinath, yes, Priya, perfect. Previous year 18-19, no depreciation will be given. No depreciation will be given, for the reason being, what is the reason why there is no depreciation for the previous year 18-19? The reason being, students, previous year 18-19, no depreciation has been given, for the reason being that the asset is not put to use. You will write the reason, not put to use. Not put to use. That is the reason why no depreciation. And as far as second is concerned, yes, there is a put to use which is taking place. But as what Priya has said, it is perfect answer. And the answer is, in the second year, it is 15%. In fact, I think here, Siva also has said it full depreciation earlier. Siva also has said it 15%. So the reason which has been given, students, be careful. That 50% of the normal rate would be applicable. Now, first of all, you copied on this and then I'll give you the answer. All of you have copied on this answer. Sri, if you have copied on this answer, then may I give you the explanation? You also write the explanation. And these are your MCQ based question. These all are your MCQ based question, students, and you can easily go wrong in these type of questions in the examination. All of you are through with this? So please write below that. 50% of the normal rate of depreciation. Please write. After that, copy this. First, you write what I'm explaining, and then you can copy down whatever is left. 50% of the normal rate of depreciation is applicable. 50% of the normal rate of depreciation is applicable when two conditions are satisfied. Point number A. Point number A, the asset is acquired during the previous year. The asset is acquired during the previous year, and point number B, it is put to use for less than 180 days. It is put to use for less than 180 days in the same previous year. It is put to use for less than 180 days in the same previous year. Underline the word same previous year. Full stop. In the present case, in the present case, the asset is acquired in previous year 1819. The asset is acquired in previous year 1819. And it is put to use, and it is put to use in previous year 1920. In previous year 1920, therefore, in previous year 1920, full stop. Therefore, the normal rate of depreciation, therefore the normal rate of depreciation shall apply, the normal rate of depreciation shall apply for previous year 1920, for previous year 1920, even if the asset put to use, even if the asset put to use is for less than 180 days, is for less than 180 days. I hope that this concept is now very clear to all of you. All of you are clear with this one now? Shall we take up quickly this additional depreciation concept? If you are taking this additional, before we solve more questions, let us take additional depreciation concept, and also I want to take this investment allowance of 32AD. Along with additional depreciation, I will also take one more concept of investment allowance of 32AD. Students, all of you will take two. Slide number 12, herein, slide number 12, the concept of additional depreciation. The concept of additional depreciation. Now, if you see over here, students, there are actually two rates for additional depreciation. The rates are 20% and the rates is 35%. Now, this 35%, students, your attempt is the last attempt. After that, 35% will not exist. Your attempt is the last attempt for additional depreciation of 35% from May 21 and November 21. This 35% is gone. So, students, generally, if the question is silent, if the question is silent, we will always go with question silent. Then take 20%. Then take 20%. Now, what is this 35% case? When 35% of the additional depreciation rate would be applicable? Let us have a look on that point. So, if the SSE has set up an undertaking or enterprise for manufacturing or production of an article or thing, for manufacture of or production of article or thing, in that particular case, students. So, for manufacture of or production of article or thing, so in that particular case, if an SSE has set up an undertaking or enterprise for manufacture or production of an article or thing on or after 1st of April 2015, in this notified backward area, which is at 4 state, Andhra Pradesh, Bihar, Telangana and West Bengal, and what? Asset is acquired and installed as stated above. About during the previous year 2015 to 31st March 2020. So obviously when it you are talking about previous year 1920, my factory is situated where? In say Telangana or Andhra Pradesh or Bihar or West Bengal, and in that notified place where my factory is situated, I am acquiring a new plant and machinery which I am putting it to use on or before 31st of March 2020. I am acquiring and installing a new plant and machinery during the previous year 1920 in that notified area. So you tell me, then in that case my additional depreciation rate will be increased from 20 to 35%. So whatever is my normal depreciation rate, say 15% is my normal depreciation rate, over and above that I will get the additional depreciation rate of 35%. This we all now know the logic behind this is that the government wanted to push industrial development in all these regions so that from backward region they can be on the mainstream, from the backwardness they can come to the mainstream, and that is the reason why the government has given the extra incentive that look, your additional depreciation rate will get increased from 20 to 35% if you satisfy the following conditions. And again I'm repeating to you, if the asset is used for less than 180 days, if the asset is used for less than 180 days, then we all know what will happen. The additional depreciation rate will get reduced from 35 to 17.5%. And the balance 17.5% on the actual cost, the balance 17.5% on the actual cost will be available in the next year. Please have a look to the additional point, students. It is over and above the normal depreciation. Point number B, additional depreciation under section 32.12A on computers used for data processing. So computers for data processing at industries is allowed. Please understand, data processing at industry means at factory. But if the question is silent, students, if the question is silent, the way it was, the question that we solved just now, can you appreciate? If the question is silent, so you should know not only the provision. Students, when you are revising income tax, you should know not only the provision, but how to read the question and then apply the provision. So if the question is silent about where the computer is used, then no additional depreciation. If question is silent about where the computer is used, then no additional depreciation. If you want to give the reference, students, question number one, we can give the reference. Which is the reference? Question number one, what we did just now, which was, I think, 4.195. I think that was the page number. 4.195 in your module. So if the question is silent about where the computer is used, then no additional depreciation. Now second part, third point number C, students, if the asset is used for less than 180 days in the year of acquisition and installation, depreciation allowable shall be in the year. How much is that? 10%, 17.5%. I've already done that. And the next year it will be the balance 10% or 17.5%. Then point number D, students. Point number D, for the time being, you can skip this point number D. And 32.12A, students, additional depreciation. What is the eligible plant? So this blue shade, students, this blue shade which is there, this is about what? The eligible plant. Or I will say in that way, ineligible plant. Students, you can write ineligible plant. So this is all about the ineligible plant. The blue shade is all about the ineligible plant. So see what they say. 32.12A, additional depreciation condition, SSC has acquired and installed new plant and machinery. So SSC has acquired and installed new plant and machinery in this regard, other than ship and aircraft. And point number B, the SSC should be engaged in the business of manufacturer production. So students, whenever a question comes of manufacturing, that the SSC is in the manufacturing business, please have the habit of underlining that part in your question, because definitely there would be some twist of additional depreciation that will be there in that question. And if the asset is acquired during the current particular previous year, then on that new asset which is acquired, you will give the additional depreciation. So the SSC should be engaged in the business of manufacture or production of any article or thing in the business of generation. So either it can be, students, either it can be so here it can be in the business of manufacture or production of any article or thing, that is point number one, or in the business of, or in the business of generation, or generation and distribution of transmission or power. So that is the two business in this case. So yesterday we have seen, students, these are MCQ important questions, students. Yesterday we have seen that the generation, the one who is in the generation or the business of the generation and the distribution of the power, for them there is an option given for the SLM basis of claiming the depreciation. There is an option given for the SLM basis of claiming of the depreciation. Now the same entity, students, Tata Power, Adani Power, the same entity, they can get the additional depreciation if they want to come in the block scheme. So if they want to come in the block scheme, students, then in respect of their new plant and machinery which they have purchased, they can get the benefit of the additional depreciation. But for that purpose, they have to come under the block scheme. That is one of the requirement that they have to fulfill. If you see the next point, point number C, where the expenditure incurred is in respect of what? Any machinery or plant which before its installation by the SSC was not used within or outside India by any other person. So it should not be used. So this is only then it will be eligible, otherwise it will be ineligible. So can I say therefore second hand plant, whether imported or domestic, whether imported or domestic is ineligible. Students, second hand plant, whether imported or domestic, they are ineligible. So that is one point. Second point is, any machinery or plant shall not be installed in the office, students, office or residential accommodation or in any of the guest house. So if it is installed in the office or in the residential accommodation or in the guest house, then again it will become what? Ineligible. Plant or machinery shall not be an office appliance or a road transport vehicle. So can I say therefore, Reliance Industry, even though it is a manufacturing company, but Reliance Industry, if they purchase motor vehicle, then in respect of the motor vehicle, will they be getting the additional depreciation? And the answer is no. Reliance Industry, students, has got also ship and aircraft. Reliance Industry also has got their ship and aircraft. So if they purchase ship and aircraft, will they be getting the benefit of the additional depreciation? And the answer is no. So motor vehicle disqualified, ship and aircraft disqualified, office appliance disqualified, asset which is used in the office premises, residential accommodation, guest house disqualified. And the last one, students, is any machinery or plant, the whole of the actual cost of which is allowed, not allowed as deduction. So it means that this particular asset cost, if it is allowed as deduction, if the asset cost is already allowed to you as a deduction in any of the section, like one example is section 35, which we will see now in our next class, section 35. So in that you will realize that the entire amount of the actual cost of that plant and machinery is allowed as deduction. Entire amount of the actual cost of the plant and machinery is allowed as deduction. So in that regard, students, the whole of the actual cost of the plant and machinery, if that is already allowed as deduction, then will this be considered will this be considered? And the answer is, no. It will not be considered as an eligible asset. So these are the four conditions, students. Now, the easiest way to remember is this one, students. I'm just putting you in the note side so that herein, one of the ways to remember the additional depreciation is like this. In the additional depreciation, for the plant, this is only for the plant. So specific plant which is disqualified, the specific plant which is disqualified is your ship, your aircraft, motor vehicle, and office appliances. Student, this is a specific disqualification. And office appliances, these are the specific disqualification. Other plants, any other plant, shall be disqualified if what? Used in the office. One more thing, students, you can write. One more point, students, you can write last. Computers. In the bracket, if not used in factory. So these are the specific plant which is disqualified. Ship, aircraft, motor vehicle, office appliance. Office appliance example, I can give an example, is books. Office appliance example is books. Computer, if not in the factory, if not used in the factory. Now, any other plant shall be disqualified if used in the office or residential accommodation or guest house. So, place of its use, students, the place where it is used. What about the second one? The second one is that second-hand plant. So, any plant which is a second-hand plant will get disqualified. And the third one, whole of the cost is already allowed as deduction. So, one, this is the way you should remember, students. Specific plant which is disqualified are ship, aircraft, motor vehicle, office appliances, and the computers which is not used in the factory. Any other plant shall be disqualified if it is used in the office or it is used in the residential accommodation or the guest house, or it is a second-hand plant, or the whole of the cost is already allowed as deduction. So this is the way in which the disqualification will apply for the additional depreciation. This is a way that the disqualification will apply for the additional depreciation in respect of the plant. I hope that all of you have got hold with this thing, because students, you will be tested. Yeah, IPCC, and they don't touch upon depreciation. It will never happen in your PGBP. And these are the areas wherein they are going to put you in the firm test to verify whether you know or not. If this condition is satisfied, students, once you have seen that, the plant is not disqualified, it does not fall within this category. Then what is the next step that you are supposed to do? Students, is to determine the rate of additional depreciation. And the rate of additional depreciation can be 20% or 35% or 10% or 17.5%, as the case may be. Isn't it? 20% or 35% or 10% or 17.5%, as the case may be. Now that 20 and 35 will depend upon that satisfaction of that condition of that four states. And only then the 35% will be the rate, or if not satisfied, then 20% will be the rate. That rate would be applied on the actual cost. And if the asset is put to use for less than 180 days, then the rate will get reduced to 50% of the actual cost in the current year, and the balance 50% of the rate of the additional depreciation will be given to you in the next year. Did you all got this one now, students? This is what covers your concept of the additional depreciation. I hope that all of you have got hold with this very important point. If that is the case, are you all through with this? Then I can just take the things further. If you are all through, then we will do now the last section, 32 AD, investment allowance. Investment allowance, which I wanted to do, even this investment allowance, 32 AD students, today in the class, I have already have mentioned 32 AD also is a part of your syllabus. And 32 AD students is your last attempt. After that, May 21, November 21, 32 AD is not there. May 21, November 21, students, 32 AD is not there. Fine, so therefore, let's give a grand farewell to this 32 AD with your attempt and your examination. So this 32 AD investment allowance for manufacturing. So if you see here, who? Person, any person, meaning you may be individual, HUF, company, partnership, firm, any person, doesn't matter. Location, factory should be set up in the central government notified backward areas in the state of Andhra Pradesh, Bihar, Telangana or West Bengal. Okay, and thereafter required to set up a new factory. So students, in the same four location that we have just spoken about it for the higher additional depreciation rate of 35%, if you will set up those factory in those four location during that cutoff period, we all know cutoff period would be 31st March 2020. Didn't I have mentioned over here last AY for deduction is AY 2021. So if you have purchased a new plant and machinery in the factory which is situated in those notified region, if you have purchased a new plant and machinery and installed in the factory which is situated in those notified region, then in that particular case, for the plant which you have installed, you will be eligible for normal depreciation of 15%, higher additional depreciation of 35%, and the investment allowance of 15%. So this is your normal depreciation. ND is normal depreciation. This is your the higher AD. This is your higher AD. And what is this 15%? This is your investment allowance, IA. This is what the SSE would be benefited from. Again, an MCQ based question. Students. Now, the first two are the depreciation. So this is all about the depreciation. The first two is about the depreciation. This is about the depreciation. So if the question only is about how much is the total claim of depreciation, if the question of MCQ is only about how much would be the total claim of depreciation in the first year, you will write 50%. In the first year, it will become 50%. Maximum, the total claim of the depreciation in the first year would be 50%. 15% is the normal depreciation, ND. 35% is the higher claim of the additional depreciation, that is 35. So that will give you 50%, first two. And as I told you, the 15% IA, investment allowance, which is separate. So this is your separate deduction. So you will have this as your deductions which are being there. So keep in mind, students, this very, very important observation which I have just now made with all of you. Did you all got this one? 15, 35 and 15%. Fine. And I think that should be all that would be required for you to understand. you can just skip this particular part. Skip this particular part. And here in students, can you see this particular part here? This is an important one. Exceeding rupees 10,000 in cash, if you have paid an expenditure cannot and exceeding rupees 10,000 in cash and such expenditure SSC cannot claim depreciation under section 32 or investment allowance under 32AD. I'm just writing here. If the value of the depreciable asset, value of the depreciable asset is paid in cash, is paid in cash in excess of rupees 10,000, in excess of rupees 10,000 on a single day, then such amount so paid will not form part of the actual cost and consequently no depreciation allowance and no investment allowance on that amount. So students, if the value of the depreciable asset is paid in cash in excess of what? In excess of rupees 10,000 on a single day, then what? Then such amount so paid will not form part of the actual cost and consequently no depreciation allowance and no investment allowance on that amount. It is just like students, your 40A3, wherein there is a disallowance section which is there. 40A3, where there is a disallowance that is attracted. But here we don't do a disallowance. Students, here we are not interested to do any sort of disallowance. Why? Because anyway students, when you purchase an asset, then the expenditure for the purchase of an asset is nothing but a capital expenditure. When you are purchasing an asset, then the expenditure on the purchase of the asset is nothing but a capital expenditure. And if it is a capital expenditure, then in that particular situation, what we will say? We will say that the expenditure otherwise is also not allowed as deduction. A capital expenditure, is it allowed as deduction? When you purchase an asset, do you take a deduction of that particular expenditure? And the answer is no. It is a capital expenditure. It goes in the balance sheet. But yes, on that expenditure, you will be eligible to claim the depreciation. On that expenditure, you will be eligible to claim a depreciation. But if the portion of that expenditure, in excess of rupees 10,000 is paid in cash, otherwise then by way of, is paid in cash on a single day, then that portion of the expenditure will not be considered as the actual cost of that asset. That particular expenditure which you have paid in excess of rupees 10,000 on a single day in cash, that portion of the expenditure will not be considered as the part of the actual cost of that asset. And if it is not considered as a part of the actual cost of the asset, on that there is no question of claiming the depreciation. Because the depreciation, be it the depreciation or be it the investment allowance, the percentage is applied on the actual cost. And if you pay the amount in cash, in excess of rupees 10,000, then we will say that this portion of the amount which is paid in cash will not form part of my actual cost, and hence it will not qualify for depreciation allowance. So I hope that this point is well taken by all of you students. If that be the case, if you are through with this one, we shall now look into the other particular problems which has been there. Yes, Ashwini, Priyanka, all of you have got good observation in this case. Shall I now take the things further? If you're all through with this, we'll do the balance remaining practical problems now from the module. Question number one, already have done it. So now let's do the remaining question. So we have discussed first one. First question, we have solved it. Obviously, there was additional deposition for which I have given you this information right now. Now, students, let me in fact give you last. Okay, before we do illustration one, students, last one particular point in the chart. So we will cover up that thing today, and then tomorrow only. So if you see in your master chart, students, in your master chart which I prepared for deposition, first was the basis of deposition. First was the basis of deposition, SLM and the block scheme. Second was the condition of the deposition. Second was the condition of the deposition. In that condition, you have the ownership and put to use. You have the ownership and put to use. In the third one, there is an eligible asset and the rate of deposition. In the third one, there is an eligible asset and the rate of deposition. And the eligible asset, we have got tangible and intangible. For the eligible asset, we have got tangible and the intangible. And the last one, students, and the last one is primarily is a miscellaneous. And in the miscellaneous part, students, we will do the miscellaneous part. Oh, sorry, after that, eligible asset and the rate of depreciation, the next one is the actual cost. Actual cost I am going to touch upon maybe tomorrow. Okay, a very small concept which we will discuss it tomorrow on actual cost. But today, we will do this one. Students, I'm just putting this in the block. In case of conversion of firm or a sole proprietary into a company, firm or sole proprietary into a company, or a private limited company or unlisted public company into an LLP, company into an LLP, or in the case of amalgamation or demerger. So there are three cases actually. First is the firm getting converted into a company, a private company getting converted into the LLP, or there is a case of the amalgamation or demerger. So in these three cases, students, in these three cases, there is a special provision. And what is the special provision? The special provision is this, that you shall claim the depreciation. You shall claim the depreciation normally. So what is the fact that you have to do? Students, you claim the depreciation normally. Forget it that such amalgamation, demerger or succession has taken place. The amalgamation, demerger or succession has taken place. Just forget that. And you calculate the depreciation normally. Okay. And once you calculate the total depreciation for the relevant previous year, thereafter you will do the split. Thereafter, students, you will do the split. Split that depreciation amount in the ratio of days, in the ratio of number of days the asset was used by the previous SSC and the successor SSC. Whatever is the amount of depreciation, that you will split between the two. Who are those two? Previous SSC and successor SSC. How you are going to do a split? The split would be in the ratio of number of days each of the person has used that asset. The ratio of number of days each of the person has used that particular asset. And that is how the split has to be done. So if you see here in point number one, total deduction of depreciation allowable to predecessor and successor company shall not exceed what? Total depreciation allowable had reorganization not taken place. Total depreciation allowable had reorganization not taken place. And point number two, Depreciation shall be apportioned between predecessor and successor company based on number of days asset were used by them. Depreciation shall be apportioned between predecessor and successor company based on number of days asset were used by them. Okay, so that is what I have told you. Now, if you see this question, which has been there, students, in this question, let's quickly do this couple of questions. There are two questions here. Mr. Gopi, carrying on business as proprietor, converted into limited company. So, a proprietary firm is getting converted into a company. Which, what is the name? Gopi Pipes Private Limited, from 1st July 2019. The details of the assets are given below. And what are the details of the asset? Block 1 at 15%, block 2 for building 10%. This is the opening WDV, students, by the way. The company Gopi Pipes Private Limited acquired plant and machinery in December 2019 for Rs 10 lakhs. It has been doing the business from 1st of July 2019. Obviously, from that day only it came into existence, because the business now is now the business has now been carried further in the form of a company. Earlier it was carried in the form of a individual. The business was carried in the form of the individual. Now, with effect from 1st July 2019, it is being carried forward in the form of a company. Compute the quantum of depreciation to be claimed by Mr. Gopi and successor Gopi Pipes Private Limited for AY 2021. Assume that the plant and machinery were purchased by way of the account paycheck. Why they are giving this information? Because they don't want the 10,000 part. Otherwise, that much portion will not form part of the actual cost and accordingly will not qualify for depreciation. Ignore the additional depreciation, if any. So, students, herein, so in this case, as it was being told to you, there are two blocks, 15%, and on that apply that rate 15%, and you get the depreciation of, how much is the depreciation? 1,80,000. Second block is at 25 lakhs, apply 10%, and you get depreciation of 2,50,000. Okay, now 4,30,000 is the total amount of depreciation. Now, individual is a previous SSE, company is a successor SSE. For how many number of days it was used by the individual? So, you have got April, and you have got May, and you have got June. April, May, and June. April 30 days, May 31 days, and June 30 days. 91 days. First, you will say, what about the 1st July? 1st July will go to the company. The day when the conversion take place, the day when the amalgamation take place, that day goes to the successor SSC. That day goes to the successor SSC. So therefore, students, 91 days, and please don't forget, you have to apply 366 days. Why 366 days? Because you, in your leap year is there, 1920. February, we have a leap year. So therefore, 91 divided by 366 would be for whom? For Mr. Gopi. Now, you can do individually also, students, no hard and fast rule. That for plant, you can do like this, 91 by 366, and this also you can do 91 by 366, and then you take the total, it will be the same. Okay, and for the balance, 4,30,000, for the balance, 4,35,000, students, herein, in this case, 4,30,000 would be for Gopi Limited, 275 days. So, simple put, how you got 275 days? You can simply do 366 minus 91 days. 366 minus 91 days. And therefore, 275 days, primarily which is used by Gopi Limited, divided by 366 into 4,30,000. Or you can do also individually the way I have done for them. That will give you what? 3,23,087. So, students, if you add these two, you will get what? The total depreciation is 4,30,000. As it has been told to you, that the total cannot go beyond, the total between the two cannot go beyond, the total between the two, students, cannot go beyond 365 days. The total cannot go beyond the normal depreciation, which is the 4,30,000. So therefore, if you that 4,30,000, you have done the split in this case. Now what about this extra depreciation which Gopi Limited is getting? The information is given to you, students, that Gopi Limited in December 19 has acquired one new plant. So obviously for that plant only Gopi Limited will be the one who will be claiming the depreciation. You will say, sir, why don't we give this for that new plant which Gopi Limited has purchased? Why don't we give this depreciation to Gopi also? Gopi will not get it because this was purchased only by the successor SSE. So was it used by the previous SSE? No. So it would only be claimed by the successor SSE, and that is the reason why it is 50%. Now why we are taking 50% or 15%? Put to use for less than 180 days. So this is 75,000. So the total depreciation, students, the total depreciation for Gopi Limited is 323,087 plus 75,000. So that is how you will have to take into account. Let's look upon to illustration 3 quickly, students. This is the last illustration. Sai Limited has a block of asset carrying, Sai Limited has a block of asset carrying 15% rate of depreciation whose WDV as on the first day of the previous year is 40 lakhs. It purchased another asset, second hand plant and machinery, for the same block. When it has purchased? For 1st of November, 2019, for rupees 14,40,000, and put to use on the same day. But can we say it is used for less than 180 days in the previous year, 1920? Is it used for less than 180 days? Yes, we can say that it is used for less than 180 days. Sai Limited was amalgamated with effect from what? 1st of January 2020, students. So can we say, therefore, January, how much days? January 31, February 29, and March 31. So this comes to primarily 91 days. 91 days is for amalgamated company. 91 days is for amalgamated company, and what? 275 days is for the amalgamating company. 275 days it is for the amalgamating company. That is what we, at least, no, 275 days, just forget it for timing, but we can say at least 91 days the amalgamated company is in existence. You are required to compute a depreciation allowable to Sai Limited and Shirdi Limited for the previous year ended 31st March 2020. Assuming that the asset were transferred, whatever price at which it is transferred has got no relevance. Also assume that the plant and machinery were purchased by account paycheck. See, always they are using this particular phrase. They are always using this phrase because the danger of this 10,000 in excess of that, if the value has been paid, then that portion will not form part of the actual cost. So therefore they keep on giving this particular information again and again. So students, let's first calculate the depreciation of the assets on the amalgamating company. So that is our first objective, to calculate a depreciation on the assets of the amalgamating company. So the WDV as on 1st of April 2019 is 40 lakhs. The WDV as on 1st of April 2019 is 40 lakhs. Additions which is made during the year when the asset is used for less than 180 days. So it is given to you already, 14,40,000. What is the date? It is on 1st of November. So total is this much. Now students, be careful. 15% I am claiming for the opening one, and 7.5% for this one. 7.5% for this one, because the asset is put to use for less than 180 days. So the total depreciation is this. But be careful, students. Please don't do the split from 7,08,000. Why I should not do the split from 7,08,000? Because the number of days the asset was used here. What is the number of days the asset was used? Total number of days. So here, if I can say the total number of days used is 366 days. Both by amalgamating and amalgamated company, I am talking about the original open WDV. For open WDV, 40 lakhs. It was used right from 1st of April 2019 till 31st of March 2020. So full 366 days it was being used. What about the new asset which was acquired? It was acquired in November. So for November 30 days, for December 31 days, for January 31 days, for February 29 days, and for March 31 days. So in all, if you see, the total number of days the total number of days that we have comes to what? So this is 91, 121, 152 days. See the difference. And in that 152 days, we can say 91 days is by the amalgamated company. 91 days is by amalgamated company, and the balance, how much is the balance? The balance 62 days. The balance 62 days is by the amalgamating company. So 91 days is by the amalgamated company and 62 days is by the amalgamating company. So that is what is the situation. Sorry, not 62 days, 61 days. 61 days is by the amalgamating company. So students, see for yourself. First asset, 366 days used. 366 days used. In the case of that particular asset. So Sai Limited for the opening WDV. Sai Limited students, Sai Limited for the opening WDV. What is the total depreciation? Total depreciation for that is 6 lakhs. How much Sai Limited will get out of 6 lakhs? 275 divided by 366. 275 divided by 366. How come 275? Obviously, you have to take from 1st of March to 31st of December. That will give you 275 divided by 366. So, that 6 lakhs of the depreciation on the opening WDV, that is a split. That gives you 450,820. Now, in the respect of the new asset which Sai Limited has acquired on 1st of November, on that the depreciation allowance is 1,08,000, and therefore the Sai Limited is getting from 1st of November to 31st of December. 1st of November to 31st of December, and that gives you what? 43,352. And therefore in this regard 4,94,162 is the total depreciation which Sai Limited will get. What about Shirdi Limited? For that open WDV, 91 days divided by 366, because Jan, Feb and March, but divided by 366 days, because that was the number of days the opening WDV asset was being used. So that comes to this. What about the asset purchased by Sai Limited on 1st of November? For that, for Shirdi Limited, they have been using from Jan to March, so 91 days, but the total number of days it was being used was 152 days, so therefore 64.658. So total becomes how much students? 2,13,838. Now if you do the total of these two, 494,162 and 213,838, if you do the total of these two, it will result into 7,08,000. The total depreciation for the year. And that exactly how you will have to take into account this particular total amount of the depreciation claim. Now students, Ashwini, next year it will be 75% plus 15%. I didn't got it, Ashwini, what exactly you are suggesting? I didn't got the Ashwini your question. All of you are through with this, student. Ashwini is asking question, if the cost is 50,000 and 40,000 is paid through cash and 10,000 in cash. So 40,000 is paid through cash and 10,000 in cash. The whole amount is ineligible. Whole amount will be ineligible. No, in excess of. No, Ashwini, it has to be in excess of 10,000 on a single day. And in your question, you are asking 40,000 in one shot and 10,000. So that 10,000, is it in excess of 10,000? No. So 40,000 in your question would be disallowed, meaning it will not form part of the actual cost, and only 10,000 will be a part of your actual cost. And 50,000 in 5 installment of 10,000, no disallowance. It will not be disqualified, because what is required is excess of 10,000 on a single day. What would be the opening WDV of the Shirdi Limited? Now Shirdi Limited, friends, opening WDV students are asking what will be OpenWDV. So Shirdi Limited has claimed 2,13,000. So your question is here. Question is, after claiming the depreciation of 2,13,838, what is the opening WDV of Shirdi Limited? In the next year. Which means 1st April 2020. This is a question. This is a question, students. Ashwini, 40,000 through bank and 10,000 in cash, nothing is disallowed. Entire 50,000 you can claim depreciation, because in excess of 10,000 in cash, only then it will not form part of the actual cost. This is a question that the students are asking now. This is the question which the students are asking. Question is, after claiming the depreciation of 2,13,838, what is the open WDV of Shirdi Limited in the next year, which is as on 1st of April 2020. Now, in the given question, students, here, in the given question, you have been given as 60 lakhs. This is the price at which Shirdi Limited has acquired the asset. Purchase consideration was 60 lakhs. For whom? For Shirdi Limited. So whether the 60 lakhs of purchase consideration will be taken as the base on which 2,13,000 will be reduced and the opening WDV of the next year will be formed? Is this the way we will arrive at the opening WDV, or there is any other means to determine the opening WDV? So question is, so whether solution, MCQ solution is whether you will do 60 lakhs minus 2,13,838. Will this give you the open WDV, or there is other particular amount? This is suspense on which you will reduce 2,13,838. To get what? The open WDV as on 1st April 2020. Open WDV as on 1st April. So what is the answer in this regard? So this is your query, question, students. Today you will ensure to get the answer, and actually this box which we have to fill it up is our last segment of the concept of actual cost. This is our last concept in your chart, students, which I have prepared yesterday. This is your concept of the actual cost, which is the last concept, and this is what we are going to touch upon in the... So Priyanka, the question is whether I will take purchase consideration as the actual cost, and from that I'll reduce whatever depreciation I have claimed, or I will take something else. Will Shirdi Limited, who is the amalgamated company, will they take the purchase consideration as the base amount on which they will reduce the depreciation which has been claimed by them, and on that basis they will arrive at the open WDV of the next year, or the base amount will be something else? This is the question that you need to get the answer as your homework for today. Did you all got this one, students? So if you know where we are in terms of our analysis herein, if you all know in this scenario, students, I'll just share with all of you. In this case, we have all done in the context of depreciation. Please be careful in your chart. Can you see? We have done now basis of depreciation, condition, ownership put to use. Ownership, three things. What are the three things, students? Repeat the three things. Possess, use, entitled to hold. Possess, use, entitled to hold the asset. So this is the condition, ownership criteria. Higher purchase, who will be the one who will be claiming the depreciation in the higher purchase? It is the higher purchaser. What about the lease transaction? Who would be the one who will be claiming the depreciation? It is the lesser, not the lessee. Eligible assets and the rate. Plus, we have also discussed the additional depreciation. Additional depreciation. We have also discussed in this concept, eligible assets and the rate plus the additional depreciation is what we have discussed. This is what actual cost of WDV is what we are going to touch upon in our next session. And the apportionment of depreciation is what we have discussed with the two practical problems that we have solved just now. And that is the biggest, this depreciation concept is the biggest concept of your entire IPCC syllables. Depreciation. And why not? Because there are very much variables which are there in this. Yes, Nishank. So therefore, this is where we are. And now if you see your, again, in your revision chart, in your revision chart, if you see big deduction, 32 done, almost done now. We are left with only one thing, which is the actual cost. So 32 AD also I have done with it. Tomorrow when I will touch upon 35 and the other 35 CCC and CCD. I'll touch upon on that. And let me see if I can touch something about 35 AD. Because once this big deduction is over, students, the small deduction, disallowance and the remaining will go very fast. Okay, it is only the big deduction that we have to be very careful. We will solve all the practical problems in respect of the big deductions which are there. And that is why we have to do this thing comprehensively. Yes, Priyanka, you can ask the query on additional depreciation. Any query, students, you have, you can let me know before we close the session for the day. I want that home assignment to be done by all of you. So assignment has been given. You will have to do it. Additional depreciation of 35% is allowed for the SSC covered under section 32AD. And he is eligible for 20% additional depreciation also, sir. No, Priyanka. Additional depreciation. Be careful. Additional depreciation rate can be either 20% or it can be 35%. One of the two rates. Additional depreciation can be either 20% or 35%. And that's additional depreciation if you want. The section for additional depreciation is not 32AD. Additional depreciation section, students, is 32.12A. The section for additional depreciation is what? 32.12A. So that rate is 20% or 35%. 35% that 4 notified, that 4 state, in that 4 state, the notified region. In that notified region, if you have your factory, in that factory, if you have acquired new plant and machinery, that your additional depreciation rate under 32.12A will be 35%. But if you say, no, my factory is not in those notified area, my factory is in other area, then fine. In that case, the new plant and machinery which you have acquired and installed, for that the additional depreciation rate would be 20%. Okay. Now this 32AD is not additional depreciation. 32AD is an investment allowance. And that investment allowance you get when you have got the factory which you have installed in that four state, in the notified areas of the four states. In the notified area of that particular four states, if you have got your factory which is installed, then in respect of the new plant and machinery that you have acquired during the previous year 1920, you not only will get the additional depreciation under section 32.12A at the rate of 35%, but also you will get the investment allowance. You will get an investment allowance under 32AD of 15%. So investment allowance is at 15%. investment allowance is only 15% primarily. And even if, please understand, even if you use the asset for less than 180 days, please be careful on this point. If you have used the asset for less than 180 days, then what I have told you, your normal depreciation will get reduced to 7.5%. Your additional depreciation in that notified area will get reduced to 17.5%. What about your investment allowance? The investment allowance which is there of 15%, the investment allowance which is there of 15%, will that get reduced to 7.5%? Is my query to all of you. Will that get reduced to 7.5%? Investment allowance, will that get reduced to 7.5%? Is the question. Say the answer, students. Investment allowance, will that get reduced to 7.5%? Nishank? And the answer is no, students. Never. Investment allowance will always be at 15%. Why is it so? Because it is not a depreciation. Depreciation is your normal depreciation and additional depreciation. Only this will have the impact, and only for these two that it will get reduced to 15%, which will become 7.5%, 35% will become 17.5% if the asset is used for less than 180 days. But investment allowance of 32AD, investment allowance of 32AD is not an additional depreciation or normal depreciation, and therefore it will be at 15% of the actual cost even if the asset is used for less than 180 days. So this is how, students, it has to be considered. So I hope that you have got hold with this particular point now. I hope that all of you have got hold with this particular point now. This is an important part, because this is where you may make silly mistake. This is where you can easily will get confused. So be very, very clear about the interplay, between the normal depreciation, additional depreciation of 35%, and the investment allowance of 3280 of 15%. If the plant and machinery is acquired and installed not in that notified area of that 4 state, if the plant and machinery is acquired and installed not in the notified area of that 4 state, then in that particular case you will have your normal depreciation of 15% and the additional depreciation of 20%, but there will not be any investment allowance. And if the asset is used for less than 180 days, then your normal depreciation will become, instead of 15%, it will become 7.5%, and your additional depreciation instead of 20%, that will become 10%. This is how it has to be considered. Did you all got this one, students? All of you are through with this? Yes, students. So 7.5% and 10% is what will be the eligible depreciation in that particular case. So students, now you all have to do that assignment which I have told to all of you. You all are aware what is the assignment that you need to do. You have to determine by reading the actual cost. You will say, sir, what is that actual cost? Where is that actual cost that we are supposed to read? So students, that actual cost, if you want to read in our chart, I can just let you know where is that actual cost in our chart. So this is where you will get the actual cost. So it is in chart number 11 itself. Students, chart number 11 itself. This part. If possible, students, read this particular part and come tomorrow. As I told you, students, we are continuing this week completely. So for the covering up that I have to do for all of you, And just give me a day or two. We will do something on the WhatsApp group or Telegram channel for taking up your queries and all. I'll make those WhatsApp group and the Telegram channel, and I'll give you the number, and accordingly we can all be a part of that particular group. Okay, so students, you can read this and come tomorrow, so that we all know that you will be in a position to get the last part. And after that, students, I'll do 35 scientific research, the big deduction of 35, 35 AD, 35 CCC and CCD. Okay, so let's target that thing for tomorrow for the big deduction. See you then, students. Any other queries are there? Or investment allowance, Prasad has asked investment allowance once again. So investment allowance, when I have said is this, that this is the last year of deduction of investment allowance. Investment allowance, you should not confuse this with, this is over and above your depreciation. This is not a depreciation, but it is over and above your depreciation. Depreciation, you get normal depreciation and additional depreciation. Depreciation, you get normal depreciation and additional depreciation. But this investment allowance of 32 AD, you get over and above the depreciation. Now, when it is applicable, when it is applicable, this is applicable when you have purchased a new plant and machinery, and you have installed that new plant and machinery in the factory which is situated in that four notified states, for factory which is situated in the notified region of that four state of Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, West Bengal and Bihar. So if you have acquired and installed the new plant and machinery in that particular, in that notified area, in the factory which is situated in the notified area of that four state, then in that particular case, then in that particular case, what you are supposed to say, SSC should be setting up a new factory in which it requires and installs the eligible plant and machinery. SSC should set up new factory in which it acquires and installs the eligible plant and machinery. Monetary threshold is there? No such threshold is there. That is what it is. And what I've told you, if you purchase and acquire and install the new plant and machinery in that notified, in the factory which is situated in the notified area of that four state, then not only that you get the normal depreciation on that plant and machinery at 15%, not only that you get the additional depreciation of 35%, not only that you get the additional depreciation of 35%, but now you will also get what? The investment allowance at 15% of the actual cost. At 15% of the actual cost. However, again I'm repeating, this is irrespective of the number of days the asset was used in the factory. So the plant and machinery may be used in the factory for, say, less than 180 days. In that case, your depreciation allowance, normal depreciation and the additional depreciation, your depreciation allowance may get reduced to 50%. That is, it will become 7.5%, it may become 17.5%. But your investment allowance will continue to be at 15%. Your investment allowance will continue to be at 15% of the actual cost. But if you say that, no sir, I have not acquired new plant, but the same has been installed in a factory, not in these notified areas of that four state, then no investment allowance would be available. No investment allowance will be available. In this case, you will be eligible for the normal depreciation of 15% and the additional depreciation of 20%, but now no higher additional depreciation of 35%. Normal additional depreciation of 20% would be available. No higher depreciation of 35% would be there, and no investment allowance would be there in this regard. No investment allowance will be there in this regard. Fine, students. So this is what it will be considered in this regard. So if you are through this, Prasad, any other queries if you have on this, let me know on this quickly. Prasad, okay, students. Fine. So see you then in the next class. in this context. Please do that particular question which I have given it to you today, and I'll see you tomorrow. 9:45 would be the timing when we'll start the lecture. Thank you.